Hello friends, in this video we are going to discuss how to create a pivot table in your Excel. This is my Excel file and this is some of the dummy data. This is GST number, name is invoice number, invoice value, taxable value, IGST, CGST and SGST. Now here you will find that there are the name of the supplier and a GST number, CG industry, multi. So there are various times the same supplier name is coming up, but it is not in a sequence. So I can find out the various report from the use of the pivot table. How can I find out? I will show you. You can just select your old data and go to the insert menu. From the insert menu here, select on the pivot table. Here you have to select the pivot table. As and when you select the pivot table, your table got selected. So this is the range of the data which you have selected. So the A1 to I44, this data is selected. Now it will ask you where you want to make your pivot table, new worksheet or an existing worksheet. So it is advisable always to create a new worksheet for the purpose of pivot table. So I am selecting on the new worksheet and click OK. So my new worksheet is open. Now here you will find the pivot table. Here you will find the pivot table field list. Now suppose I want the GSTN in my row. So I just select on a GSTN. You will find that in my row GSTN is coming up. Now suppose I want my name of the supplier in the row, then I just select on the name of the supplier. You will find that the GSTN and the name of the supplier is coming on the row. Now suppose I want the invoice value in the column, then just I select on the invoice value. You will find the sum of invoice value. You can also select your formula. Just click here instead of sum. If you want count, then just select on the sum and select on the value field setting. Here you just select on the count, you will find the count. Suppose if you want the taxable value in your column, just select on the taxable value, you will find here. If you want integrated tax, just select on the integrated tax. If you want central tax, just select on the central tax. If you want state tax, just select on the state tax. Now sometime it may happen that your particular column value is coming on the row side. Same for example, if this value is coming on this side, same for example, integrated value is coming on the this side, but if you want in the column instead of row, then just select here and just press on the value table. So now your integrated value is coming on the column table. So here you will find that your pivot table is ready. Here it is a GST number, but and in the downside you will find the name of the party. However, if you want the name and GST number in the different column but the same row, then just click on the option button. From the option button, here you have to select the display and here you have to select the classic pivot table. Just press OK. You will find that my GST number and the party name. So this is the party name, his GST number. You will find that the total number of count in my data for this party name. You will find the sum of this taxable value for this party. You will find the sum of central tax. You will find the sum of state tax. Now here, after each party name, you will find the total value. Suppose if you want to remove this total, just click, right click. As and when you right click, here you will find the subtotal GSTN supplier as a right click. Just click on it, you will find that the total value is disappear. So this is the pivot table is ready for your data. From the pivot table, you can find out the various report easily. Same for example, from here, if you want to find out the details of your CG industry, all bills total, all his taxable value total, number of invoice, you have to count manually, or you have to filter, or you have to sort. So instead of filter or sort or counting manually, just create your pivot table, and by pressing pivot table you can find out easily that for this particular fight, total 3 invoice, total of taxable value is this, total of CGST is this, total of SGST is this. So in this way you can create a pivot table in your Microsoft Excel. Thank you.